I'm here at NSpine with Dennis Cirino, one of the developers of the Integrated Global Alignment Platform from NuVasive. Dennis, how did you get involved with this platform and how did you come to develop it?
Back when I was previously running the thoracolumbar group at NuVasive, and we were all meeting to develop the next platform for ourselves, and we were actually going down the path of a new pedicle screw system. During those meetings, all of us sat together and just kind of agreed that what the industry needed right now was just not another pedicle screw system. So we were really striving to do something much greater and really something that could move a market and make things easier for surgeons. And just in a couple of the meetings, we had broken our own team internally, made up of marketing and engineering, as well as a large group of surgeons into multiple groups to say, you know, you guys talk about logistics, you talk about the equipment, you talk about education, et cetera, et cetera. And we were listing things that were important. And one of the things we found that was just incredibly in common among all the groups, every group identified alignment as an unmet clinical need. So we really started to dive into a lot of the work and the research that's been done in the past by surgeons along those lines, which really put us on the path to if we could help achieve alignment, which is tied to greater outcomes, that would be a great service for the whole industry. So that's really how we came upon it.
Yeah, of course. I wondered what challenges do surgeons face when it comes to alignment?
Yeah, it's a very complex issue, and I'll even say clearly, nobody's figured it all out yet. You know, if it's a crawl, walk, run type of approach, we're probably still crawling in a lot of ways. But what's been great is we've been learning a lot. With some of our technology now, we're able to capture measurements live during surgery that we weren't able to previously, which is really teaching us and teaching surgeons. One of the biggest challenges we had, though, however, was in theory, it was kind of always perceived as a deformity principle, the whole concept of pelvic parameters and alignment. And taking a deformity principle and trying to make that very common in more the degenerative marketplace, which is a bigger marketplace, was really quite challenging because some surgeons would say, well, that doesn't apply to me. I just do one or two level cases. But, you know, as we're learning in a lot of literature and from more and more experience that we're getting, it absolutely does matter in degenerative cases. So that's been a challenge, is taking, you know, that, you know, one philosophy and trying to broaden it to the bigger audience.
What is unique about the IDEA platform in particular?
There's a number of things. I would say the biggest underlying feature that's very unique about it is there are multiple planning platforms out there, and companies have them, implant companies and non-implant companies. But you make a plan, you make a great plan, and then it stops. And then they go into the operating room and you know, do the best that they can. The thing that made IGA completely different from everybody else is that we took it from a preoperative plan. We integrated it live into the operation intraoperatively, and also created an element after the surgery where you can confirm, did you actually achieve your plan? So I think for the first time, and to our knowledge, the only ones that have it, something that truly scans across the entire procedure from pre-op to post-op.
So it seems like you've achieved a lot so far with the system, but like you said, we don't have all the answers yet.
We do not have all the answers yet, but we'll keep working.
Where do you think developments will go in the future with this kind of technology?
Yeah, I think that's a great question, and hopefully I don't have all the answers for that too, because every time we turn around, we're finding another way we can implement some element of IGA into some of the other things. But NuVasive's been it started a product company, it became a procedural company, and we're really shifting to become a systems company, quite honestly. And what I'm seeing happen now is as products get developed within our portfolio, they're all created with IGA in mind, with ties to IGA, so that everything we're doing can be tied to alignment and hopefully better outcomes for everybody. So I think you're going to continue to see more development, always in the implants. We're always going to be an implant company, but certainly in the way of computer-assisted surgery with a very distinct tie to alignment goals, and hopefully better outcomes.
Well, thank you for explaining the system to me.
You're very welcome.
It looks like we have a lot of exciting things to look forward to in the spinal arena.
The future looks very good.